Trump survives assassination bid. Shooter killed seconds later. Deadly sniping action on camera. US Secret Service completely fails its one duty. American gun laws debate heats up.
Take a look at what happened.
Repeated slip-ups put Trump's life in danger. The Trump assassination bid. The US Secret Service failed at the one job it was entrusted with, the protection of a former president of the United States. What was the anatomy of this shameful, humiliating near miss that goes on to stain the record of the Secret Service? I'm going to break it down for you here on 5 Live. I'm Shiv.
Take a look at what happened.
It might as well have become the campaign motive of the Republicans this election. Images of Trump being shot at with a bullet grazing his ear and then him holding his fist up while bleeding from his face has become the most central image in what is now turning out to be the most tantalizing American election. President Donald Trump narrowly escaped a potentially deadly attack during a campaign rally in Pennsylvania. It was a minor injury, but that bullet, if it had moved just this way or that with his head, would have ended Donald Trump's life. There is no doubt about it. Let's start first with what happened.
Take a look at what happened.
Former US President Donald Trump narrowly escaped death after a shooter opened fire at him during an election rally in Butler, Pennsylvania, on Saturday. Trump sustained a minor injury in his right ear and was seen clutching his bloodied ear as U.S. Secret Services surrounded him and escorted him off the stage. A day after the assassination attempt on Trump, the Federal Bureau of Investigation named 20-year-old Thomas Matthew Crooks as the suspect, who was shot dead. The attacker was armed with a semi-automatic AR-15 gun.
This evening we had...
The FBI says it'll probe Trump assassination attempt as an act of domestic terror, even as motive of the attack is yet to be identified.
Take a look at what happened.
Trump thanked law enforcement agencies and said that God prevented the unthinkable. The Republican leader went on to say that he loved his country and that it is important to stay united. Trump is in Milwaukee in the US to be a part of a crucial Republican convention where he will be formally named as the presidential candidate. Former First Lady of America, Melania Trump, spoke out for the first time after the shooting. She condemned the assassination attempt and urged Americans to set aside political differences to consider leaders as humans with families. President Joe Biden, in his address to the nation after the shooting, called for a lowering of temperature in politics.
Last night, I spoke with Donald Trump. I'm sincerely grateful that he's doing well and recovering. And we had a short but good conversation. Jill and I are keeping him and his family in our prayers. We also extend our deepest condolences to the family of the victim who was killed. The FBI is leading this investigation, which is still in its early stages. We don't yet have any information about the motive of the shooter. We know who he is. I urge everyone, everyone, please, don't make assumptions about his motives or his affiliations. Let the FBI do their job and their partner agencies do their job.
Take a look at what happened.
The images of Trump's fist pump right after the shooting has rallied his voters and donors. The incident could help Trump bolster the lead he already enjoys over Biden in popular ratings. Bureau Report, India Today.
20-year-old Thomas Matthew Crooks was the sniper who shot Trump, hitting his ear. He could have easily killed the former president, but fortunately he missed and only hit his ear. Who is Thomas Matthew Crooks, 20 years old, a registered Republican from Trump's own party? The FBI says it's investigating a potential act of domestic terrorism, which is rare. But the absence of a clear ideological motive by the man, shot dead already by the Secret Service, so they can't even interview him, has led to a huge number of conspiracy theories after this monumental security collapse. Take a look.
A day after gunshots rang out at a Trump rally in Pennsylvania, investigators are now digging into the past of this man, Thomas Matthew Crooks, as the suspect in what police call an attempted assassination. It's unclear how the 20-year-old managed to get close enough to shoot at Trump from a nearby rooftop with an AR-15-style rifle. The FBI says he acted alone. On Sunday, the police presence was heavy in Bethel Park, where Crooks is from, about an hour from the rally site. This video shows him at his high school graduation. Jason Kohler, a classmate, described him as a loner.
I mean, he would sit alone at lunch. I mean, he was just an outcast, and you know how kids are nowadays, and it's honestly kind of sad. Like, I don't want to say this is what provoked it, but you never know.
Crooks was shot and killed by the Secret Service. One attendee also died, a 50-year-old man that Pennsylvania Governor Josh Shapiro described as a hero.
We lost a fellow Pennsylvanian last night, Corey Comparator. I asked Corey's wife if it would be okay for me to share that we spoke. She said yes. She also asked that I share with all of you that Corey died a hero, that Corey dove on his family to protect them last night at this rally.
Two other people were wounded in the shooting but are in stable condition. Leaders on all sides of the political spectrum condemned the shooting. Democratic President Joe Biden on Sunday reiterated that there was no place in America for violence.
An assassination attempt is contrary to everything we stand for as a nation, everything.
Investigators say they still don't have a motive for the attack. Trump is now due to receive his party's formal nomination at the Republican National Convention, which kicks off in Milwaukee, Wisconsin on Monday. On Sunday, the Secret Service said it was confident in its security plans for the event and was not anticipating any changes because of the shooting.
Well, apart from the investigation itself, what does this incident actually mean for the Trump campaign? Remember, there have been some ups and downs in his campaign, but you can only imagine how this has energized and galvanized the Trump campaign team. For starters, obviously there's going to be sympathy and support from undecided voters who could be the big deciding factor this American election. Trump's defiance, the way he held up his fist with that bleeding face, you know, it positions him as a strong leader, someone who can still stand despite facing a bullet. It also shifts the narrative of him, confirms the narrative that his campaign has been using and proposing for a long time, that opposition forces are trying to target him. Now he gets to basically tell the American public that the opposition forces want to kill him. And finally, it tilts the electoral dynamics. Remember, President Biden has already been on the defensive because of his health, but now concerns over Biden's health vis-a-vis and juxtaposed with Trump looking like something of a strong man could tilt the electoral dynamics significantly. And remember, this isn't even at a time when Biden is on a strong wicket. Now, the spotlight on the U.S. Secret Service couldn't possibly be harsher. This is a country where access to firearms and assault rifles of the kind that were used by Thomas Crooks to fire a bullet at Donald Trump are sometimes more easily accessible than everyday groceries. The U.S. Secret Service, tasked specifically with protecting current and former presidents, is part of the Department of Homeland Security. And right now, it's got egg on its face, perhaps like never before, after this failed assassination attempt. And remember, this is a country where presidents in the past have died to assassin bullets. What could the Secret Service have done that it did not do on that particular day? Take a look.
Take a look at what happened.
The U.S. Secret Service is confident of security plans at the Republican National Convention. Donald Trump is attending a day after the miraculous escape from assassination attempt.
It's been an 18-month process. We've worked together over that 18 months to develop operational security plans for any and all aspects of security related to this event.
But did it change within the last, has any change been made in the last 24 hours?
We're not anticipating any changes to our operational security plans for this event.
Take a look at what happened. Oh.
The FBI and the Milwaukee police are also backing up the Secret Service, now under severe criticism for the Saturday debacle. Experts believe the shooter of the assassination attempt had limited capability, knowledge and training, and yet he was close to killing him.
I would have expected that local law enforcement, at the direction of the Secret Service, would have been positioned on those rooftops. You allocate one to, more likely, two to three officers to take positions along that rooftop or that roof line. But that apparently wasn't done. The other aspect that we'll have to find out is, obviously, civilian witnesses observed this individual.
We couldn't see him, but we could hear him. So we walked up, and probably 5 to 7 minutes of Trump speaking, I'm estimating here, I have no idea, you know, but we noticed a guy crawling, bear crawling up the roof of the building beside us, 50 feet away from us. So we're standing there, you know, we're pointing at the guy crawling up the roof.
And he had a gun, right?
He had a rifle.
A rifle.
We could clearly see him with a rifle, absolutely. We're pointing at him. The police are down there running around on the ground. We're like, hey, man, there's guy on the roof with a rifle. And the police were like, huh, what? You know, like they didn't know what was going on. You know, we're like, hey, right here on the roof. We can see him from right here. We see him. You know, he's crawling. And next thing you know, I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, why is Trump still speaking? Why have they not pulled him off the stage? I'm standing there pointing at him for, you know, 2-3 minutes. Secret Service is looking at us from the top of the barn. I'm pointing at that roof, just standing there like this. And next thing you know, 5 shots ring out.
So you're certain that the shots came from that guy on the roof?
100%. 100%.
And he was up there for a couple of minutes.
He was up
you
there.
You saw him up there for a couple of minutes.
Absolutely. At least 3 to 4 minutes.
And you were telling police and the Secret Service.
We were telling the police. We were pointing at him for the Secret Service, who were looking at us from the top of the barn. They were looking at us the whole time when we were standing by that tree.
Could they see
binoculars?
Him? Could they see him?
Probably not, because the roof, the way the slope went, he was behind where they could see.
The eyewitness account identifying the attacker minutes before points glaringly at the loopholes that the U.S. Secret Service finds hard to answer at this point.
I don't know what to say, man. All I'll tell you is, you know, if I walked up close to there with anything that Secret Service considered a problem, I wouldn't be standing here talking to you right now. But I don't know why a guy who we're standing there pointing out to police and Secret Service is crawling up the roof. Yes, right there by that tree. We were outside the security perimeter. But my question is, there's only a few buildings around here. Why is Secret Service not on every building here?
Well, there's a whole bunch of questions, I think, that are going to come.
There's a whole bunch of questions.
This individual was able to make an attack on the former president with limited capability, knowledge, and training And that concerns me because what if there was somebody that was really trained in how to assassinate someone? Would it have been accomplished? That concerns me as to how somebody that from the first blush now, I don't know very much about this individual, if anything at all, a novice versus a trained assassin.
A sniper employment officer who has led several combat missions in the past, identified as Blake Hall, called the attempt an easy shot on a social media post, as there were major security lapses due to which the shooter could engage Trump from at least 130 meters. Tesla maker and ally Elon Musk has called for the U.S. Secret Service leadership to resign. So did Republican House of Representatives Speaker Mike Johnson, and added that other appropriate officials from the Department of Homeland Security and the FBI should appear for a hearing at the earliest. Many social media users and Trump supporters have pointed out the absence of drones at the campaign rally, that even experts believe could have kept a watch on buildings outside the security perimeter, but still close to the venue. Bureau Report, India Today.
A former president with a bullet grazing his ear is about as big as it gets if you're talking about a security system failure by the Secret Service. Now take a look at the multi-level failure by the Secret Service, which had this one job to do. Potential threats were obviously not adequately assessed beforehand, which is why nobody knew what was going to happen at that particular rally. The high ground, vantage point positions were not entirely secured by the Secret Service. This is basic. Any small police force knows about this. The Secret Service didn't ensure it. Perimeter security breached despite checkpoints and magnetometers. How did a guy with a rifle get within a few hundred meters of the rally location? Secret Service didn't locate the gunman until shots were fired. And as you just saw in that report, there appear to have been visitors and attendees of that rally who had actually called attention to someone crawling on that roof. Delayed real-time response by agents after Trump attacked. That embarrassing video of fumbling Secret Service agents unable to holster their pistols, adjusting their sunglasses, running around, falling around, not knowing what to do as they secure the president, has truly put a very, very scary spotlight on the agency that is literally, literally tasked with nothing else but protecting the body of the president and former presidents of the United States. Now, obviously, as you can imagine, there's a huge blame game politically between the Republicans and the Democrats over this assassination attempt on Trump. The Republicans say Biden's campaign painting Trump as a threat to democracy has triggered the shooting. A similar war of words, remember, is also playing out in India, which is also a country that is no stranger to assassinations of leaders. Take a look.
Take a look at what happened over.
The Donald Trump shooting continues to reverberate across the globe. In America, the Republicans and Democrats are trading charges, accusing each other of creating the atmosphere that triggered the assassination bid. In India, too, it has triggered an explosive war of words, with the BJP accusing Congress MP and leader of opposition Rahul Gandhi of inciting violence against Prime Minister Modi. It even raked up the security breach during Narendra Modi's visit to Punjab's Firozpur in 2022. The BJP claims that Congress is creating condition for political violence in India by calling the Prime Minister a dictator and anti-democracy.
Congress party ki sthiti ye hai ki jab thok mein haar hoti hai to rulai. और जब फुटकर में जीत होती है तो जुलाई फुटकर में थोड़ी बहुत कहीं जीत हो जाएगी तो फिर विरोधी राजनीतिक दल पार्टियों की धुलाई शुरू कर देंगे तो इस तरह की रुलाई धुलाई जो है वो सियासी सेहत के लिए हानिकारक होती है उनको समझना चाहिए.
The Congress has called the BJP's attack at Rahul Gandhi cheap politics and has accused the Prime Minister and the BJP of inciting hatred against its party leadership.
RSS is an organization which spreads heat. Congress is an organization which spreads love. We all know that Mr. Rahul Gandhi ji's family members too. Two of them, Indira Gandhi ji as well as Rajiv Gandhi ji, has been victim of political violence. He stands for love and affection, and these kind of fake news factories of BJP will be defeated.
Take a look at what happened.
In an extremely polarized world, will such rhetoric only create deeper divides in democracies? Bureau report, India Today.
So the bullet that went after Trump was an assassination attempt on a presidential candidate, a former president who is running for another term as president. But here's a look at those who've been in office and been killed. Abraham Lincoln, most famous 16th U.S. president, assassinated in 1865 in a theater by assassin John Wilkes Booth, who shot Lincoln in the back of the head. James Garfield, U.S. president, was assassinated 6 months after taking office. He was killed in 1881 in Washington at a train station. William McKinley, U.S. president, assassinated in 1901 by an anarchist in Buffalo, New York, attacked while shaking hands with supporters. Most famously, John F. Kennedy, killed in 1963 by a hidden assassin with a high-powered rifle. The killer, Lee Harvey Oswald, was shot dead 2 days later. He was shot in a victory procession in his car with his wife, Jackie Kennedy, by his side. Now, Donald Trump has been a front-runner in this U.S. election, and now he becomes much more than just a front-runner. The U.S. presidential race is now hotting up after that narrow assassination miss. The bullet grazed Donald Trump's ear, and it's a miracle nonetheless that the former U.S. president cheated death. But remember, amidst all of this, there are those who claim to know more about why Trump was able to cheat death. Take a look.
Take a look at what happened. Over.
Trumping death by a few millimeters. Donald Trump survived this fatal assassination bid, and it's nothing short of a miracle. Donald Trump turned his head a wee bit, and that ensured that the bullet, instead of ripping through his skull, hurt his ear. And now, Hindu religious group ISKCON also has said that it appeared to be a divine intervention which saved Donald Trump. ISKCON has claimed God's hand to Trump being alive today, citing a 1976 incident.
हम लोग सभी लोग बहुत ही आश्चर्यचकित हो गए जब सवेरे देखा किस तरह से डोनाल्ड ट्रंप बाल-बाल बच गए. आप देखेंगे कि मिलीसेकंड में वो उन्होंने माथा घुमाया जो 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 बुलेट का जो डायरेक्शन था उनके एकदम मिडिल ऑफ द पीछे बैक के हेड में था लेकिन जैसे ही उन्होंने सर हिलाया तो वो बुलेट उनका कान में छेद करते हुए निकल गया. तो सभी लोग बोल रहे हैं इवन इंक्लूडिंग डोनाल्ड ट्रंप. उन्होंने उनका सबसे पहला रिएक्शन जब आया तो उन्होंने कहा कि ये भगवान के कारण मैं बच गया. ये गॉड इंटरवेंशन है.
अ यंग ट्रंप बैक देन 48 इयर्स अगो प्रोवाइडेड अ ट्रेन यार्ड फॉर कंस्ट्रक्टिंग रथ फॉर द यात्रा एंड ही डिड इट फॉर फ्री. To date, ISKCON bhakts remember this favor from the former president.
अगर वो जगह उस समय हमें नहीं मिलता तो शायद 1976 में ISKCON न्यूयॉर्क में रथ यात्रा शुरू नहीं कर पाता. तो 1976 में डोनाल्ड ट्रंप ने रथ यात्रा जगन्नाथ रथ यात्रा को बचा लिया न्यूयॉर्क में. और 48 वर्ष के बाद जब पूरा विश्व रथ यात्रा का उत्सव मना रहा है, आप देख रहे हैं कि कल भी रथ यात्रा 9 दिन का फेस्टिवल होता है, आज उल्टा रथ है. तो उस समय रथ यात्रा के उत्सव के समय जब डोनाल्ड ट्रंप को जरूरत पड़ी तो जगन्नाथ ने रेसिप्रोकेट किया.
Divine interaction, luck or sheer fate. Donald Trump is clearly lucky to be alive, going by what a close shave it was. Bureau Report, India Today.